We are at Camp Shakamak in Jasonville, Indiana. Basically what we're trying to teach is a multitude of things. We're trying to teach about global hunger, as well as the new movement of aquaculture, as well as underlying team building activities with working together and bouncing ideas off of each other.
Today they're feeding fish, or they're learning how to feed the fish so that we can feed the population in the future in about 2050. They're using aquaculture and building a fish feeder.
To put it simply, aquaculture is growing fish. It's raising fish for food, and that is key in global hunger because it doesn't require a whole lot of space. We are teaching them tools that they could use in aquaculture, and it's very heavily based in the STEM education with the science, technology, engineering, and mathematics. This is very engineering based, as well as the science with the aquaculture tied in with the agriculture and 4-H. Essentially, they have the Fish Farm Challenge mats, which is the title of this event.
They are given a few rolled up newspapers, a string, a funnel, and a bucket with fish food in it, and they have to build a freestanding structure to feed the fish.
It has three circles on the bottom. It's supposed to simulate a fish tank, and they need to distribute the fish feed equally throughout in the three circles so that all the fish get fed equally.
In order for them to get, for the fish to kind of know, I guess, where the food is, you put it in the same place. So they're learning how to put them all in the same area, the general area, so that the fish will know where to come to get the food.
So it's sort of a simulation of how actual aquaculture farmers have to think about their feed distribution systems.
It's great for to use the younger kids because they have great imaginations and are able to think, oh, well, we could do this. We could use a lever. We could do poke holes in the funnel. We could poke holes in the bucket. And they just use their imagination. And a lot of the kids are really good at team building. Some of them, it's more of a struggle. But for the most part, they're all really good at working together and to get a task done.
It's a pilot program that 8 states are currently participating in. I was selected as one of 3 4-H members who went to Washington, D.C. to be trained on this program. This entire program is actually sponsored by Monsanto because they have the big push for the global hunger and the 9 billion people on planet Earth by the year 2050 needing to be fed.
Shakamak's a great time. I love coming to 4-H camp. I was a camper. I love doing all of this stuff, hanging out with my friends and making new ones.
Basically, we're just trying to find the best way for the kids to have fun, learn the STEM education, educate about the global hunger and the new aquaculture push, and just tie it all into one activity that they're going to enjoy and remember.
I've learned that it's harder to build a freestanding feeder than you would think it is.
I feel it went pretty well.